Dear students, how are you? I think all of you are well. In this pandemic situation, I welcome you all in chemistry online class. Today, I am going to discuss with you about organic acid. I know all of you know about this organic acid. So, watch this class from first to last, then you will gain your necessary knowledge from this video class. Okay, students, let's start the class. So, students, what is organic acid? Organic compound in which monovalent carboxyl group, that means COOH group, is present, known as organic acid. That means the organic compound in which COOH group is present, known as organic acid. Another name of organic acid is fatty acid. So, if any question arises that what is fatty acid or what is organic acid, then your answer will be the organic compound in which monovalent COOH group is present, known as organic acid. The general formula of organic acid is CnH2n+1COOH. So, this is the general formula of organic acid. Now, if here the number of N is 1, then it will be CH3COOH. Now, how the name of organic acid is done? Just look at here. Here 2 carbon is present. You know, if 2 carbon is present in alkane, then it will be ethane. So, for the naming of organic acid, E of alkane is replaced by OIC acid. That means it is replaced by OIC acid. So the name will be alkanoic acid. The name will be alkanoic acid. Now, as here 2 carbon is present, so it will be ethane. But here E is replaced by OIC acid, so it will be ethanoic acid. So the name of this compound is ethanoic acid. Again, if there are more than 2, that means 3 or 4 carbon is present, then what will be the name of this compound? Or if there are 1 carbon is present, just look at here. If there is 1 carbon, then it will be HCOOH. If there is 1 carbon is present, then the formula will be HCOOH. So, you know, if 1 carbon is present, then the alkane is known as methane. Now, the E of methane is replaced by OIC acid. The name of this compound is methanoic acid. So, this is the naming of organic acid. But, students, the another name of this methanoic acid, you must know about this another name of this methanoic acid. Another name of this methanoic acid is formic acid. Formic acid. And do you know what is CH3COOH or what is ethanoic acid? Ethanoic acid, another name of ethanoic acid is acetic acid. And 6 to 10% aqueous solution of ethanoic acid is known as vinegar. I think, students, all of you are clear about my keyword. Now, let's start the preparation of organic acid. Organic acid can be prepared by using several ways. First of all, by the oxidation of alcohol, then by using Grignard reagent, then by using toluene, you can prepare organic acid. Let's start the first preparation by the oxidation of primary alcohol. So, our first preparation is by the oxidation of primary alcohol. When primary alcohol is oxidized in presence of acidic K2Cr2O7 solution, then it is converted to aldehyde. So you have seen it is ethanol and its name is ethanol. So when primary alcohol is oxidized in presence of acidic K2CH2O7 solution, then it is converted to aldehyde. Now, when this aldehyde is again oxidized, in presence of K2CH2O7 and sulfuric acid, that means the solution of potassium dichromate, then it is converted to ethanoic acid. So it is converted to ethanoic acid. This way we can prepare ethanoic acid or organic acid from primary alcohol. Now come to the second process. The second process is by using Greek nut reagent. So by using Greenard reagent. By using Greenard reagent, you know alkyl magnesium halide is known as Greenard reagent. So I have taken alkyl magnesium halide. When alkyl magnesium halide reacts with carbon dioxide, then first of all it is converted to unstable compound. Here what happened? This CH3 is joined with carbon and MgX, that means magnesium halide is joined with oxygen. So the compound will be like that. OMgX and here CH3. Now when this one is hydrolyzed, so just have a look. If this compound is hydrolyzed, so CH3, double bond O, OMgX, when it is hydrolyzed in acidic medium, you know in water there are two parts, one is hydrogen and another one is hydroxyl. Now hydrogen replaced this magnesium halide. So what happened? What will be the product? Here the product is CH3COOH, it is ethanoic acid. And the byproduct is MgOHX. So by this way we can also prepare ethanoic acid. Now come to the third preparation from toluene. When toluene is oxidized, you know this is toluene. When it is oxidized in presence of alkaline KMnO4 solution, then it is converted to benzoic acid. So it is benzoic acid. This way we can prepare fatty acid or organic acid from several compound. I think students, all of you are clear about the preparation. Now come to the order of strength of different organic acid. So students, if the question is arise that what is the order of strength of different organic acid like methanoic acid, ethanoic acid. If one chlorine atom is replaced from this CH3, then it will be chloroethanoic acid. Then if two hydrogen atom is replaced by chlorine, then it will be dichloroethanoic acid. If three hydrogen atom is replaced by chlorine, then it will be trichloroethanoic acid. So what is the name of this compound? First one is methanoic acid. First one is methanoic acid, then it is ethanoic acid, then it is chloroethanoic acid, क्लोरो क्लोरोइथानोइक एसिड, देन इट इज डाइक्लोरो इथानोइक एसिड, इथानोइक एसिड, द लास्ट वन इज ट्राइक्लोरो इथानोइक इथानोइक एसिड. सो वी कंपेयर द ऑर्डर ऑफ स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ दिस फाइव ऑर्गेनिक एसिड. टू स्टार्ट द ऑर्डर ऑफ स्ट्रेंथ बिटवीन दिस फाइव एसिड, दैट मीन्स मिथानोइक एसिड, इथानोइक एसिड, chloroethanoic acid, dichloroethanoic acid and trichloroethanoic acid, you must know why organic acid are acid. Because organic acid acts like acid because in this acid COOH group is present. COOH group is present. You know oxygen is electronegative. So it attracts the bond electron to itself. That time this oxygen is partially negative. So, oxygen is electronegative, it attracts the bond electron to itself. That time, this oxygen is partially negative. Oxygen is partially negative and this carbon is partially positive. To decrease this positivity, carbon attracts bond electron of carbon oxygen. That time, the oxygen density of electron is decreased in this oxygen. So, to increase the electron density, oxygen attracts electron from oxygen hydrogen bond and this hydrogen is replaced by SH+. That means in this compound the following things is occurred, that is like this, it is C. In this surroundings, this negative charge is surrounded, so that's why the COOH group containing compound are acid. Now, what is the order of strength between these five acids? So, students, first of all, you have seen that here methanoic acid. Then come to ethanoic acid. In ethanoic acid, one alkyl group is present. You know, alkyl group is electron donor. So, it donates electrons to this carbon of carboxyl group. You know, you have seen that when the density of electron is decreased in this carbon, then it attracts the bond electron from COOH group. Just look at here, it is ethanoic acid. When density of electron is decreased in this carbon, then it attracts the bond electron from COH bond. But if this CH3 group supply electrons to this carbon, then the density of electron will not decrease in this carbon properly. That time it does not attract electron from CO bond. So the density of electron is not decreased in this oxygen and it does not release this hydrogen as proton. That means the order of strength will decrease. Come to chloroethanoic acid. What happened about chloroethanoic acid? If you draw the structure of chloroethanoic acid, then it will be like this. You know, chlorine is more electronegative than oxygen. So when oxygen attracts bond electron from this carbon, that time chlorine is also attracts bond electron from CH2 group. So the density of electron is decreased in CH2, so it attracts the electron from this bond also. That means the carbon in this carbon, the carbon of COOH group, the electron density is totally decreased. So to fill up this density of electron, electron density, it attracts the bond, it attracts the electron from here and hydrogen ion will release as proton. With the increase of this chlorine, that means when for dichloroethanoic acid, when another chlorine group is joined with this CH, then this two chlorine group attracts electron from CH. So the density of electron is totally decreased in this carbon. That time it swiftly attracts electron from the COH group, COOH group, and the density of electron is totally fall down in this, in the carbon of COOH group. Now for trichloroethanoic acid, if another chlorine atom is increased here, so what happened? Now this three chlorine atom attracts electron from this carbon. So just look at this carbon, it is just vanished because three chlorine atom from surroundings attracts electron from itself, so the density of electron is totally spoiled here. That time this carbon swiftly attracts electron from COOH group, so the density of electron is decreased in this carbon and it easily releases proton. So with the increase of chlorine group, the strength of acid, the order of strength of acid is increased, because with the increase of chlorine group, the releasing of proton is increased. That's why, you know, students, that's why the strength of trichloroethanoic acid is near about the strength of concentrated, dilute hydrochloric acid. You know, organic acid is a just dilute acid, because we have handled vinegar in our hand, in our neck hand. But this trichloroethanoic acid, but have you any time think that you can handle hydrochloric acid, nitric acid, that means inorganic acid, by your naked hand? It is not possible. We just think about this, but we can handle this type of acid, that means ethanoic acid, methanoic acid, because this is a dilute and less strength acid. But the strength of this trichloroethanoic acid is as much strong as like dilute hydrochloric acid. That's why we can't handle it by our naked hand. So the strength of order of strength of this trichloroethanoic acid is more than this 5 acid. So what is the order of strength of this 5 acid? First one is trichloro, then dichloro, then chloroethanoic acid, then methanoic acid, then ethanoic acid. So the order of strength is trichloroethanoic acid is greater than dichloroethanoic acid, which is greater than chloroethanoic acid, greater than methanoic acid, is greater than ethanoic acid. So this is the order of strength of organic acid. Now come to the identification of organic acid. So let's start identification of organic acid. When we add sodium hydrogen carbonate in the acid solution,
so it is RCOOH. When we add sodium hydrogen carbonate in this solution, then carbon dioxide gas is produced. So it will be RCOONa plus water plus carbon dioxide. Carbon dioxide gas is produced. If we pass this gas in a lime water, then it is turned to turbid. By this way, we can identify carboxyl group in solution.
Okay, students, no more today. Hope all of you are understand about each and every topics which I have discussed in my class. Okay, goodbye.